Hello. I reckon it is time to sever the wicket. Oh boy. Oh, there is a lot going on already. Oh boy. There's a lot of stuff here. Maybe I should have kept my plasma gun out, because I do have quite a bit of ammo for it. And there is quite a lot of stuff to deal with right now. Alright, looks like we have another pretty open level, at least. So, we have some places to hide. Aha. Excellent. I like the open levels because it usually means the arrow is going to be pretty easy to find. Unlike the weird little self-contained levels. The tiny little, like the first level of this episode. You know, I think when you get the arrow, I don't think it doubles your damage. I think it doubles the amount of damage enemies take from any source. Okay, there's the exit. Because, like, I just saw, like, I think there was a shotgun guy who got jibbed by an imp fireball. And that's not normally something that's supposed to happen. The imp's fireball does not normally do that much damage. And I've seen it happen a few times. In enemies being jibbed by things that they're not supposed to be. Like, I've seen zombie men jibbed by shotgun guys. You know, when I have the arrow and the key, stuff like that. So, I suspect that it's not just my weapons, it's more of an overall damage doubling for enemies. Which is interesting. I wonder if the reason the developer did it like that is so you don't accidentally deal double damage to yourself with a rocket launcher. I always thought it was gibbed because I didn't realize that the source of the term was giblets. Of course, that's when an enemy isn't just killed, they don't just leave behind a corpse, they leave behind this gross little bloody pile of viscera. It's quite unpleasant. I could do without all of the bloody corpses and piles of viscera, to be honest. It's not something that I feel adds a lot to the experience. When I did my mod, the Hoofinit mod, where you fight a large number of cyber demons, I thought that having, you know, all those identical corpses laying around the level, I thought it looked pretty bad. Oh god. Oh, there's another Baron up there. Excellent. So I replaced all of the bodies with candles to show you that you've been there, but make things a little bit more pleasant to look at, and I thought it worked okay. Of course, you do see a few candles that are just part of the natural level decorations, but never in those kind of numbers. So anytime you see more than a couple candles in one area, you know that you've already explored that part of the level. Of course, you could always just look at the map as well, but it's nice to have some sort of indication that you've been somewhere without having to pull the map up. Okay. Oh, excellent. More health and rockets. Good. I wouldn't mind picking up a key. I mean, I wouldn't mind picking up the key, but also one of the keys that's not strictly necessary, just so I can have an autosave to work with. I really shouldn't have my rocket launcher out if I don't know where I'm going next. Oh yeah. Oh, this is bad. I mean, it would have been even worse if I had the rocket launcher. Oh boy. Oh well. I have what I need. I can leave. I also have 3 health, which means any random zombie man. Okay. I have a little bit of a buffer now. Still not where I would like to be. Of course, you know, with 3 health, any random zombie man in the periphery would be able to take me out in one hit. Okay, let's leap over. Nope. I was going to say, let's leap over this lava pit, but this level had other ideas. Okay, another blind teleporter. I guess all teleporters are blind teleporters until you step into them. Huh. Oh, there's the exit. Oh, nice. Okay. Let's grab some of this pistol ammo / chain gun ammo. Let's hop over here. I guess I could grab this invulnerability and then go exploring to see if I can find some health. Okay. The exit is pretty easy to spot there. Oh, that's weird. Like, the flickering of the radiation suit fading with the inverted color effect looks kind of strange. Okay, that lowers this, which... Is there anything... There's a backpack over here, and invisibility, berserk box, or berserk pack, and the invincibility wore off. Alright, let's... I'm playing with fire a little bit by not just going to the exit, but I would really like some more resources before I continue on to the next area, which I'm getting pretty lucky here. Oh, good, excellent. Grab the blue key. That'll save my game. Okay, not nearly as many enemies on this level as I was worried about. Unfortunately, to get back to the exit, I'm probably going to have to do a little lava plotting. Oh boy, that's not ideal. Oh, okay. I thought I might be able to just walk along this ledge here and go get that invisibility sphere. Okay, well, I have a save with full health, so... If I'm not happy with the way things are going, I can always reload that. This looks like a place. It's not. Or if it is, it's not a place I can open. Oh, well, never mind. Yeah, there's a chainsaw there. That would be nice to have. Let's take care of this Baron from a distance. That sounds like a good plan. Did I get him? No, I still hear... Still hear... Yep, there you are. Okay, so I can walk on this ledge to get that sphere. There's a mega armor. It's good to have. Oh, do I already have a chainsaw? I guess I do. Don't remember grabbing it. Grabbing that backpack is... that's nice. That doubles the amount of ammo that I can carry in each category. And it also gives you a little bit of ammo for, you know, a little bit of each type of ammo, but not much. It's sort of a negligible amount, which is a bit of a shame. Because every backpack you find after the first one is essentially useless. It's like the minimal ammo pickup for each weapon. Okay, I think I'm about ready to call it a level here. So I need to get back into this structure. Which means dropping back down here. Okay, so I don't actually have to go through the lava. That's nice. Alright, climb these stairs. Circle around here. I have a good amount of ammo now. Okay. I have severed the wicked. Well, I severed 90% of the wicked. Close enough. Unruly evil. Oh, well, they've been quite, you know, agreeable up to this point, so I guess they're allowed to have a bad day. This is probably one of the weirder tracks on the soundtrack. It's kind of just a pleasant little sort of repetitive folk rock bit of, you know, guitar music with some spoken word samples, distorted spoken word samples on top of it. It doesn't sound satanic per se, you know, it's not like backwards distorted speech, it's just kind of some weird poetry, I guess. It reminds me of, if you are familiar with Pink Floyd, they have a track called, I think it's like Alan's Psychedelic Breakfast or something, which is just a little bit of, it's like a pleasant little music loop with someone talking about breakfast foods over it. I don't know what the spoken word samples in this one are about. I never really paid that close attention, but they don't seem offensive as far as I can tell. Okay, so that lowers that elevator, which is where the exit is. But the exit is just a hole that you drop through instead of a teleporter, which is kind of strange, dropping a little deeper into hell, I guess. Hello, friends. Thank you for waiting for me. So I expect that if I go through the other teleporter, it will open a similar door on the other side and lower these bars. Let's see if that happens. Yep, there we go. Make use of some of these numerous rockets.
I do not truly want to know what I just asked you. I sincerely beg your pardon.
Ow. Where are you? I saw you. Quit hiding. Okay, so the exit is open to us, but of course we are still missing the key component here. So we have some lava we can drop down into, which I'm not really keen on. I always thought it would be cool if Doom would have some, like, healing springs, like, as opposed to lava that damages you, if there was, like, a pool of water that you can stand in and it would heal you. That would be kind of cool. But that's not a thing. Might be possible to make that a thing with modding. I mean, anything's possible with modding. You could use the Doom engine, theoretically, to make just about any kind of game that you want. Well, the GZ Doom engine, at least, which is more flexible and extensible than the original Doom engine. Oh, hello. Well, I'm glad I thought to mash my face against this random torch, because that's where the arrow was. Would have been very sad if I had to spend hours running around the level trying to figure out how to get that. Actually, still don't know how to get that, because I cannot. Oh, okay. I can, if I stand here. There we go. Excellent. There is another teleporter that I'm probably going to have to go through. Oh, that's nice.
I owe them money.
Whoa. Oh, there you are. Hi. Hi. Should have just run for the invincibility sphere. Oh well. I hate being hit by hitscan weapons and just having no idea where it's coming from. It's not a good feeling. Oh, okay. So that guy was able to hit me because I lowered the elevator. Did I see? I thought I saw a soul sphere. Yeah, there it is. Dang it. Leave me alone. I don't want any. Alright, let's just go for it. Grab that. Grab the soul sphere. See if there is anything else in the lava pit. There's some medikits up there. Don't know how to get to those. I'm sure one of these pillars probably lowers if I mash my face against it. Okay. That just takes me back here. Well, that wasn't very fruitful. Okay, where is the Keymaster? It is in that direction somewhere, which there's not really a lot in that direction. Oh, I see which of the pillars I would have had to press to get all the health and stuff. You can see that green line there. I'm sure if I activated that would have lowered it. Okay, so there's either another secret off in this direction, or there is an enemy waiting to be teleported in. That's the thing with a lot of these more complex levels. A lot of them have segments where enemies are teleported in from an entirely different part of the level because, you know, they have to be somewhere. Oh, well, this looks safe. Usually when you see one of these... Oh, hi. One of these pentagrams, that means a Baron of Hell is not far away. The inverse pentagram with the satanic goat face that usually indicates some sort of boss monster. Alright, I think it's just a straight shot to the exit now. Well, this wasn't too bad. So far, the levels have not been as bad as the first two. Okay, 21 minutes, not bad. I have to move my OBS window to see the recording time. Oh, and another weird track with some spoken word stuff. See, you can tell I didn't put as much thought into the soundtrack for this episode because I have two weird spoken word tracks in a row. I probably should have spread those out a little bit. Oh well. It'll be fine. I mean, episode 4 isn't as good as episodes 1 through 3, so it makes sense that the soundtrack isn't as good either. In the actual music for this episode, it just reuses music from the first three episodes. So, you know, by including more music, I put more thought into the soundtrack than they did. You know, they just reused tracks from episodes 1 through 3. Which means if you don't like the music in my music mod, rather than loading up the episode 4 one, you can just load the other three and it will play music from previous levels instead. I was reading the wiki for the first couple levels of this episode because I was curious who designed them, and it mentioned that a lot of people consider them two of the hardest levels in Doom, so I don't feel too bad about struggling with them as much as I did. Plus, I was making things harder on myself by using the Keymaster mod and not auto-saving, or not quick-saving, rather. So, all things considered, I think I did okay. I played through Doom 64 recently, and I had a pretty good time. It was a well-designed, you know, basically another set of Doom levels with some Doom 2 elements and redesigned sprites and textures and stuff, which I think looks pretty good. It also has a new weapon and a new boss, which is interesting. One weird thing about it that I didn't really think about at the time was I don't think enemies can open doors in that game. Like, there were numerous situations where I would escape a dangerous situation by running into a room, letting the door close, and I don't think the enemies ever follow me through it, which is weird. It's kind of a big aspect of this game, is that the enemies are smart enough to open doors and chase you down. Oh, there's a soul sphere down there. I don't know, I'll have to replay it to be sure, but I don't think that's a thing that ever happened. I like to remove barrels as a potential hazard in the future. Because I'm much more likely to be blown up because I was standing next to a barrel than I am to use the barrel to my advantage. So whenever I see one, I like to take it out of the equation, provided I'm not hurting for ammo or anything. I probably should have gotten that soul sphere, since I have the radiation suit. Oh well. And I'm back where I started. I'm really not a fan of lava floors. Like, sometimes it gives you enough radiation suits to deal with them. But sometimes it can take me a while to figure stuff out. You know, longer than the radiation suit lasts. And it's just, it's not adequate for me. I don't really know where I'm going, by the way. It sure looks like I do, huh? I am moving confidently in a number of directions here. Oh, there's a key. Can I just... okay, good. That's easy. Okay, so having a save makes me feel not quite as bad about the lava floors, because if I do have to trial and error my way across them, I at least don't have to start the level completely over. That's the main reason I desire autosaves on most of these original Doom levels, to be honest. Bunch of rockets up there. Don't know how to get to them. Never did go through that teleporter. Teleporters are scary. Oh, so that's how I get to them. Teleporters aren't as scary as they are in Doom 2 and Final Doom and levels where they start to get really mean, because they really like to just teleport you in the middle of a hell situation and it's obnoxious. Like, I feel like as the series progresses, in order to make it harder and harder to satisfy the fans who demand it, they just put a lot more trial and error bullshit in. Like, you know, giant lava or acid areas where you just have to load your save over and over again while you explore all of the damage tiles and, you know, learn where the teleporters are that teleport you in the middle of a bunch of barons. Oh, well, look at that. Do I have a BFG yet? No, I don't. I could try to figure out how to get that one, but I might not care that much. No, I don't. They will repent. Well, we'll see about that. Okay. Against the Wickedly. I think all of the level titles in this one are references to Bible quotes to really hammer home the hell, the satanic hell aspect of this game. The evil, satanic, hell underworld. I think I got hit by a shotgun guy across the way. Usually, when you take a sudden massive amount of damage and you have no idea where it came from, it's just a shotgun guy that you can't see. At least in Doom 1. In Doom 2, it's usually chain gunner, but you can tell which one it is by the pattern in which you get hit. Another soul sphere I don't have access to yet, and might not. Oh well, I'll be fine. Oh, specters. That's fun. Oh, I see you. There you are. One convenience that Doom didn't have, that they later added to first-person shooters, is some sort of indicator of where the damage is coming from. Like some sort of red line on the screen that sort of shows you the direction from which a bullet came, so you're not just completely, you know, in the dark. Okay, I was gonna be like, well, damn, I should have gotten that invincibility, but this isn't a typical gate I can just activate and lower. There's a button to lower it somewhere that requires a red key to lower, but who knows where. It's probably not safe to try to rocket these cockos. Chocolate cocko. Okay. Yeah. However, I lowered this gate. It's not something in the immediate area. Gonna have to go lava swimming, which sucks with the amount of health that I health and armor that I have. But I don't see another way out of this area. This might be a restart. See? You just have to trial and error your way around or get lucky. Like, I just happened to. To activate that pillar, I could have gone around mashing my face around the perimeter, but I was fortunate enough to either guess or half remember what I had to do there. Because I do definitely remember these levels. It's been a while, but they are. Somewhere in my memory. In the deep parts of my subconscious. I don't know if I'm actually hitting that baron or not. I'm stalling for time because I'm going to have to drop back down into the lava. With 21 health, I don't like it. Unless I can run into that little passageway there, but I don't think that's very likely. I'll try it though. Nope. Well, I'm mutated. You're ready for a lot of mutations. Well, at least the music has calmed down a bit. I say, as if it's just an abstract thing that I have no control over, and not the decision that I made in the past. Oh my god, how did that shotgun guy see me when I was standing like here? I hate that. Sometimes the AI is smarter than you think it should be. Cause that shotgun guy must have, like, got a shot off and then hid behind that tree. This hell tree. Growing out of this perfectly flat. Plot of hell dirt. Oh, hi. I get both of them? Yes, I must have. Whoa. Interesting. The secret actually showed up on the map. Well, sort of. I think this was a blue line before I entered the secret zone. So it was actually visible, which isn't usually the case with secrets unless you enable that option in the GZ Doom menu, which I didn't. There's an option to have all of the secrets visible, and you can also make all of the keys visible. Oh. Well, you were being awful quiet. It's an interesting sound effect when you shoot the lava. I never really noticed that before. I think that's a thing added by the Smooth Doom mod. It adds a few little visual and audio effects to some things. I think that's one of them. The little splash that you get in liquid. Oh right, this room. This was fun. This was a fun little room. I'm having fun. I was smitten by that cocoa demon. Not smitten with the cocoa demon, although if that's what you're into, there are fan fiction sites where you can see those kind of scenarios. No, I was smitten by the cocoa demon, which is a different thing. And that blue key has just been up there the entire time taunting me. Save your game. Pick me up and save the game. That's what it's saying when it calls out to me. Fudge! God, I hate how quickly they can get a beat on you. It is not fun or cool to see a shotgun guy and immediately take like 25 damage. You wouldn't think a shotgun guy would be one of the scariest enemies in this game, because it's one of the very first enemies you see. But at a distance, in the original Doom, there's really nothing worse than a shotgun guy. Especially one that you can't see. Maybe I should try the other fork here. Instead of going left, I'll try going right. I don't think I've been that way yet. Let's just make sure that there are no specters there to surprise me. Okay. Let's see if this is any better. I still hear demons. Oh, hi. Probably nothing I can do about that. Well, either I have been this way, or it looks exactly the same as the other way. Oh god. Oh well, as far as secrets go, this one is kind of underwhelming. An invisibility sphere. Not the most useful item to find. Oh. Well, that definitely helps. Can I? No. It almost looks like this parapet can be lowered, or however you say that word. The thing on the castle. That's a parapet, right? Parapet? I don't know. It's not a word I use a lot. Nope. I was wrong. Or is a parapet some kind of seating arrangement? Also, wow, that soul sphere didn't last long. I might be thinking of a different word. Okay, well, at least I have this radiation suit for now, so I don't have to immediately drop down into Kako Land. Although, it's not going to last forever. Nothing good ever does. Do I even want to drop down there? Will it do anything for me? I'm just going to have to go through more lava. I guess it's at least a different part of the lava. Oh, a radiation suit would be really nice. Okay, I remember this. The last time I made it here, I had almost no health with which to drop into the lava. Baron of Hell is not easy to hit from this side. Right. Yeah, this is where I died. Because I tried to run into that chamber and it didn't work. I don't really have a better plan. I mean, if I run to that pillar and step onto the teleporter from a different side, it might take me to a different place. And it didn't. No secrets here. Oh, I see. If I am able to run through there. Okay, I know where that is. That's where I stepped out and started fighting the Kako demons. I really wish I could just quick save. I mean, I can. There's nothing stopping me, but is it more entertaining to let me quicksave here, or is it more entertaining for me to beat my head against a wall until I figure this out? Okay, radiation suit there. Okay, where can I go besides that teleporter? I have no idea. I don't see any other escape or exit. So I resort to face mashing. The last refuge of a scoundrel. Okay, it must be stepping onto this teleporter from a different side. Like, that has to be it, right? Or do I have to... Yep, that's what it was. Okay, I hate that. And yeah, I thought that would be the case. Like, I definitely remember struggling with that. At some point. That's not nice. Oh, hey. Well, there's the Keymaster. I don't have the arrow yet. I haven't found a single skull key. And I'm going to have to deal with the Keymaster just flinging fireballs at me for all eternity. Aha! I spy a secret. How do I get there? Who knows? But I spy it. How do I get anywhere? Who knows? I see a cockademon there in the distance. I see all kinds of goodies, all kinds of good stuff that I would like to have. Can I run through this little window? Oh, God, I have 34 health. I cannot run through the window. Okay, well now I'm over here. That's fun. At least there was some health there, thank God. Boy, this imp is really going to cramp my style. I was hoping that Baron would be... Oh, there's another Baron. Nice. Crud. I tried to sidestep, but I was in a little alcove area, and I got stuck on the terrain. Oh, man. Did not find a single key that entire run. And now the Keymaster is someone else. And the arrow is in another place. Never even suspected that I was close to finding the arrow on that run. Well, I mean, I am making progress in this level, technically, as I'm relearning how to do it. I don't like teleporters that take you somewhere else depending on which side of the teleporter you enter from. Like, that's not an intuitive thing at all. I don't want that. I don't like secret doors that are not distinguished at all from their environments, and you just have to mash your face against every wall and hope you stumble across something. Not a fan of that. And I mean, this stuff could work if they had given you some sort of tools to help discover them, I guess. See if I can lure the Spectre out with splash damage. Might actually not physically be able to fit through that. That doorway. Okay, well, I took it down. Oh no, they can fit. They were just being stubborn. Really don't like wasting this radiation suit, but if I don't at least kill the shotgun guys, they're just going to whittle my health down. Speaking of which, I don't need to worry about that Spectre. I don't know why I am. Oh, just delaying the inevitable. If I can take out that Baron of Hell from over here, that makes things a lot easier when I eventually have to go over there. But with it being behind those barriers that I have to line my shots up to shoot between the slats, it's going to take a lot of splash damage from rockets. Unless I can get lucky and just happen to nail it as it's in that position. I can't tell if the rockets are actually going between the slats or not. And it's too far away to get an accurate shot with the shotgun. Against the Wickedly. Level 6 of Episode 4. Tune in next time for more Doom. Bye, everyone.